the beginning, the baby was born. God chose Mary to be the mother of Jesus. Listen again to these words. God chose Mary to be the mother of Jesus. And when Jesus looked up into Mother Mary's face, you could already see the cross. And when the baby looked up into Father Joseph's face, he could already see the cross. And they fed him and gave him everything he needed to grow. Well, that baby, he grew. And when he was 12, he and his family and all of their friends went to Jerusalem, to the temple, to celebrate one of the high and holy days. And when they were leaving, Mary and Joseph could not find Jesus. They searched all around the city and all the markets and places where they thought Jesus went to play. And you know where they found him? They found him at the temple, talking to the rabbis, the teachers. And when he spoke, they listened. And when they spoke, he listened, because he wanted to learn so much. And of course, Mary and Joseph asked Jesus that one question that every child does not know how to answer. Why did you do this? But what Jesus said to them was strange. Do you know why I am in my Father's temple? They did not understand at that moment, but later they would. Boy grew into a man. And when Jesus was 30, he began to do his work. He went to the River Jordan to be baptized. And when he asked to be baptized, he met a man named John the Baptist, who we can see right here on the side of the picture. And when John baptized Jesus, everything became clear. John said, "I should not be the one baptizing you. You should baptize me." Some people said that when Jesus was dropped down into that dark water, that when he came up, a dove descended down from heaven above Jesus. And other people thought they heard a voice saying, "This is my son, who I am well pleased." Jesus walked into the desert. He stayed in the desert for a very long, not a long time, 40 days. And while he was in the desert, he heard a voice. That voice asked him, "If you are hungry, turn these rocks into bread and eat." Jesus said, "It is known that one cannot live just by eating bread, Christ then brought Jesus to the very top of the temple and asked him, throw yourself down and ask that all the angels catch you and raise you up. And Jesus said, no, we do not put the Lord to the test. Finally, the voice brought Jesus to a high place where he could see many, many lands. And he said, you can be the king of this entire kingdom. Jesus said, no, I will be a king, but a different type of king. Jesus went to the people in the cities and towns and began to do his work. He healed many people, spoke to many others, showing them the love of God. While he was in these cities, there were 12 that followed him and helped him in his work. He spent many days with the 12, teaching them as well, on the Mount of Olives and in the Garden of Gethsemane. After many years, he turned to Jerusalem for the last time. And when Jesus entered Jerusalem, people began to praise him. He came into Jerusalem not on a mighty horse, but on a donkey that he didn't even own. And the people broke palm branches from the trees and waved them in celebration. Our king is finally here. Now Jesus came to Jerusalem and he taught the people on a Monday and a Tuesday and a Wednesday. And on Thursday, the Roman guards began to look for him, but they could not find him, because that night, Jesus was in the upper room of a house with the 12, having supper. And Jesus told them something very strange. He said, when you break this bread, I will always be with you. And he said the same thing about the wine. When you drink this wine, I will be with you. Remember me. The 12 didn't understand what this meant, but soon they would. That evening they walked in the city in the darkness quietly, and one of the 12, Judas, kissed Jesus. And when he did, the soldiers came out of the shadows and found Jesus. And they led him away back into the darkness. And the 12 also disappeared into the darkness. That night was a very confusing night. The soldiers took Jesus outside the city walls and crucified him. And everything became dark. later, Jesus died. And when he died, some friends took his body and put it in a cave and rolled a stone over it to seal it. On Saturday, the day after Jesus' death, it was one of the quietest days on earth. It was probably so quiet you could almost hear the earth breathing. Then, on Sunday, the women had the courage to come and visit the cave where Jesus was buried. And when they came, they found Jesus in the bread and in the wine. We can't remember Jesus without remembering this. We also can't remember Jesus without remembering this. When we try to separate these two, we can't. Because Jesus is with us always. And Jesus changes even the color. Beautiful. I don't know if everything's right here. I don't know if our story should be in a line with an ending. I wonder if there's something we can do about that. Let's see. We have a beginning,
we have a middle, and we have an end.
But there seems to be a different way that we can think about this. There. I think we have our story. Everything about this story continues to this day. There is no ending because we have a new beginning with Jesus, and Jesus is with us forever. Amen.